What are you doing?
Well, I know how you and the other senior officers have been, disappointed with the rations lately, so I thought I'd use a few of the vegetables from the hydroponics bay and whip up a little breakfast.
You have turned this into a galley?
It wasn't easy. I had to completely reroute the mess hall power conduits and scrounge a lot of supplies from all over the ship, but that's my specialty, making something out of nothing. I know it doesn't look like much now, but in a few days, you'll swear there'd been a galley here for years. And careful, that one is a little spicy.
Neelix, who approved this?
Well, no one.
Well, you might have asked me first. This used to be my private dining room.
What, your dining room?
If you had checked the ship's directory, you'd have noticed that cabin 125 Alpha, deck 2, is designated as the captain's private dining room.
Oh, then I guess that you'll be wanting me to move all of this stuff out of your way?
Bridge to Captain Janeway.
Go ahead.
We're approaching the rogue planetoid, Captain.
On my way. I want you to come with me. We will deal with this later. Do we have any coffee left?
No, but we have something even better.
I don't want something even better. I want coffee.
Really? It's made from a proteinaceous seed I discovered on an expedition.
Never mind. I'll use one of my replicator rations for coffee.
That would not be appropriate, Captain.
I beg your pardon.
You need to set an example for the crew.
Well, thank you for reminding me.
You're welcome.
Gentlemen, may I recommend the Alfarian hair pasta today?
Hair pasta? That is just an expression, isn't it?
Not at all. No, it's actually made from the follicles of a mature Alfarian. We harvest the hair during shedding season in early fall. It's very high in protein.
Whatever. We just have a lot of bridge operations business to discuss.
Mr. Kim, please report to the bridge.
Have a nice lunch.
I beg your pardon.
What the hell are you doing?
I'll kill you!
It's too late! I'm betting your hair pasta already did the trick!
Janeway to Lieutenant Barris, Mr. Neelix. Janeway to Tuvok.
Yes, Captain.
Could you join us in my ready room, please?
Right away.
Lieutenant, Mr. Neelix has heard on good authority that one of our crew will be leaving the ship in a few days. Naturally, he's curious about the identity of this person. What are the security issues here?
I don't believe there are any serious concerns, Captain. There is no need to withhold this information any longer.
Mr. Neelix has asked to be put off the ship. Energizing.
His lungs have been removed.
By the time we got to him, he was unconscious.
How could anyone remove his organs so quickly?
The doctor says whoever did this used some kind of transporter to beam the lungs directly out of his body.
What happened?
It appears that Neelix was attacked. We don't know how it happened, but someone has surgically removed his lungs.
Doctor, wait, don't leave.
I'm not leaving, Mr. Neelix. I'm simply going back to work.
I can't see you over there. I feel like I'm all alone.
You are all alone.
I really need to get out of this restraint. Doctor, I want you to let me out of this thing right now.
You know that's impossible.
You're not the one trapped in a restraining field with hollow... hollow lungs. I don't think they're working. I can't get enough oxygen. There's something wrong.
You're hyperventilating. Try to take slow, natural breaths.
I can't. I'm dying. Let me out of here. Let me help me. Help. Help me.
Should have said something.
Nobody could have predicted this, Tom.
How shall I proceed?
The Talaxians mourn their dead for a full week in a specific burial ceremony. And that's just what we are going to do.
I'll inform the crew.